I wanted to jump on and do a planner flip of my new A5 that I have set up, and I am so loving the size, and I had so much fun putting this together, so I kind of wanted to do a video and show you guys what I did and some of the DIY projects that I did. I'm going to be linking all of the items that we have in here that's in our shop, as well as the other shops and the inserts, so let's get there. So here is my front page, and I love it. It's so pretty. I have this cute little card in here. You can see it's so beautiful. It's from Sequins and Paper. I just thought it was really cute, so I love to keep it right there. This is my main first page, and I love it so much. It is so cute. So basically what I did is I took one of our crystal clear fly leaves, you can see here, and I put this really pretty like matte sticker across the top. And I love that, like, it goes from frosted to clear, and it's so pretty. And I love this little saying. And then I took a number 2 pocket. We have these in the shop as well. And I stuck that on the front, and then I just put some of our transparent stickers in there. And I thought it was just a really cute way to hold the stickers and make, like, a cute front of your planner. So the next, I did the same thing. This is a clear sticker pocket from Foxy Fix, and I stuck it on another one of our clear flyleaf dividers. I just thought it was really pretty. These are some page flags from Cloth and Paper, and this is a really beautiful freebie that you get when you order from Infinite Lotus. I just love it. I think it's just so beautiful. And then this is, oh my gosh, I love this. This is my favorite. So with this, I took our clear flyleaf divider again, and I stuck on our number 6 pockets. And here, let me show you. So let me see if I can get that in there. So you can see here, I just took 4 of our number 6 pockets and I stuck it right on the front of this divider, the clear divider, and they fit the Maddie Plans task cards perfectly. They also fit our task stickers and credit cards. It's just really, really cute and so functional. I love it because it's crystal clear. I know there's some out there that fit these cards, but they're kind of that frosted plastic or that like that soft frosted look, and I really like this like transparent clear look, so I love it so much. And then the kind of the same thing with this, with our another one of our clear dashboards, and I put our task stickers in there, the ones that I use most often, and then I have the cute like lunar phase sticker set that I'm using to track the moon phases, both monthly and weekly. That's my goal this year. And then we have the table of contents, and I love this one. It is so beautiful. So I printed this on acetate, and I just love it. I'm obsessed with it. It's so cute. Like, it's so like shiny and cute and just so pretty. Absolutely love it. We will have some open spots available for custom table content dashboards. I'll post more about that on our Instagram, and we'll have them available in the shop. I just love it so much. So it says table of contents, and it has editor-in-chief Savannah Baker. Then it has all my planner sections. And this cute little quote down here, it says, "When the vision is clear, strategy is easy." And I just love it so much. And then I have it backed with this really pretty piece of vellum just to give it some more depth and dimension. So beautiful. So my first section is my inbox section, and this is kind of my catch-all for everything. And I am loving these inserts, you guys. They're so perfect. So these are from Plan with Julie B on Etsy, and I will link it below. It's literally out of my mind onto paper, and I just love that because that is one of my biggest planning hacks that I do, is I just literally try to get everything out of my mind, all my ideas, my tasks, and just put it down on paper. And it has a really cute key right here to like help you figure out your tasks, if you've done them, if you've moved them over to another list, or if they're completed or canceled. So those are really, really, really cute. Then I have my 2020 holidays. And then I have this, which is a dashboard that's available in our shop. It's my Post-it inbox dashboard, and I love this. It's so helpful. So basically what it is here on the side, it says urgent, remember, top priority, and then here is to do, to buy, and tomorrow plans. So what I do is when I have different tasks throughout the day, I put them on this top Post-it note, and as I finish them, I cross them off, and then at the end of the day when I know that there's tasks that I didn't get completed or that I have to do tomorrow, I write them down here, and then I just move this Post-it to this, and I put a new one right here. So it's kind of like this rotating Post-it inbox, which really helps. I love it. So my next section is my monthly section. I am waiting on some inserts from Elemon Paper Co. There's a really, really pretty monthly insert set that I got. but I kind of wanted to set up the section and get ready for it anyways. So what I did was I found this online for the food, like the moon phase tracker, and I cut it out, printed it, cut it out, and then I put a number 2 pocket, we have these in the shop, on top of my divider, and I kind of just slipped that in there. You can see here, it's just in the little pocket, and this is like so helpful, because normally when I plan, I'll try to do it like that week, because I'm going to do weekly and monthly, and just like going online and trying to find it every time. It's just such a waste of time. So I put it right here on the front of the monthly section so I can just flip to it. Super duper easy. My next one is Timeline, and I am waiting again on some inserts from Elmont Paper Co. I will do another flip of those. There's a really cute like a gold timeline, and I think they're like they go horizontally and they just look really really cute, so I made a section for that. The next section is my goal section, and I love it. So this is one of our new journaling cards that we have available in the shop, and I thought it was just so perfect for a goal section, so I put some tape on it, and I stuck it down onto the top of this divider, and I just love it. It says, you can, end of story, which is perfect for a goal section. So these are my goal inserts. They are from Cloth and Paper, and I saw Maddie Plans have this really, really cute way of how she laid this out, and I love it. So I'm going to be filling these out probably this weekend. What she did was she used each section here as like personal, work, financial, or any kind of thing you want. So you can divide it into 4 sections of your goals. And then you have the monthly, so 1 month, 3 month, 6 month, and a year. And then what she did was she broke it down, so she would have her main goal, and then she broke it down into 2 or 3 tasks that she can do to achieve that goal. And so you can do 2 tasks, 2 tasks, 2 tasks, and hopefully in a year it's complete, or sooner, depending on that, which I really, really liked. So I'm definitely going to be setting that up. It has a reflections page and future goal planning. I just love it. So here is, this is a set that we have in the shop. It's our Live by the Sun set, and I just love it. I love it layered. So it is 2 dashboards here. It's just so pretty. I love it. Next I have my sticker sheet. I custom made these for my Elmont Paper Co. weekly inserts, and I'll show you how I use them in just a second. These are my task stickers. This is a full sheet of stickers. You can see here we have these in the shop as well. I love it because I can literally flip to this in the beginning of my weekly section and just pick the stickers that I need and put them in. And I also can pre-plan out the entire month with these, and I love it. It makes it so easy. I don't have to get out my sticker albums, my books, my packs of stickers. It's just right here, easy, done, on the go. I love it. So here are my Elmont Paper Co. weekly inserts, and I am just loving these, you guys. They are so perfect. Like, my brain just likes them. I didn't think I would, but I printed them out, and I was like, you know what, just give it a try, and I am so glad that I did. So these are printables from Elmont Paper Co., and what it is you have, it's a vertical and horizontal. And what it is you have different sections, and then these are the days. So I did the urgent, work, personal, and other, and then you go across. So here on like Monday, you have the urgent, work, personal, and other, and then you can just plan it out accordingly, and I love it. I think it's so cool. You can see here how I use my Maddie Plans task flags, which I absolutely love. We have some of our transparent teardrops and dots and corner flags. And then here I'm using the really cute task stickers. And I love these. And this is a today page marker from Cloth and Paper. And next I'll show you kind of what, here I pre-planned that out, along with the dates and the moon phase. And this is kind of what it looks like without any of the stickers. So it's a blank up here. And what I did was I took these stickers and I just put them up here to kind of do my sections. If there's enough interest, I'll probably list these on our shop as well. And next I have my list section. This is kind of my catch-all right now for my page flags. But these are just lists that I have for my home, office, and the work, and the business. I have a project list insert that I did, which I really like having it sectioned into different projects, and then you can cross off the different tasks for each individual project, which I really like. Next list is, I made this, I know it's kind of crazy, I have so many highlighters, and honestly, like, the color of the pin cap does not match half the time, does not match the highlighter at all, so I kind of wanted to swatch them all out, so I made this insert for myself. So basically, I just swatched out the highlighter, and then I put the brand and the color name right here, and I used my label printer, my P-Touch Brother label printer for these. And I love how it looks, and it's really, really easy to look at and pull which color you want. Because I tend to do my weekly spreads and like a color scheme or a theme or a certain palette, and this really helps. I have that for my grays and then my pinks, and I have more that I'm going to be doing because I have so many eyeliners. That's okay though. And then I have my ideas section, and this is all my ideas for upcoming products and all that kind of good stuff. Next is my workout section. I love this so much, you guys. This is awesome, awesome insert. This is from Plan with Julie B, and it's her yearly tracker. And what I plan on doing with this is using a highlighter and marking off all the days that I go to the gym. And that way I have a good idea of how many times I'm going and how committed I am, and it'll keep me like on track and keep me accountable for that. Next is workout plan. I love this insert so much. This is from Infinite Lotus, and it is a, you can see here it says exercise, reps, sets, and duration. So I love the fact that I can put in what I've been doing at the gym, or when I go to my personal trainer, I can put that in and I can remember the exercises for next time when I want to do it myself. And it also helps me see like my improvements. I have a bunch of my other ones written down on a just regular paper. So I'm going to transfer that here. And I think it'd just be really cool to see how you progress through the year, or, you know, with your workouts. So next one is my digital dash ideas. I have yet to set this section up. I like to plan out my monthly themes for digital dash on paper and kind of just do vision boards and do storyboards with it and kind of really just have fun with it. So I'm hoping to add this to my planner. Next is my financial section. I am waiting on some inserts again from Elemon Paper Co. Her and Maddie Plans did an amazing collab with these business financial inserts, and I cannot wait to get my hands on them. They look so cute and so functional. They have like your expenses and your income, and if you have different sources of income, just amazing, amazing. So next is my bills section, and I made this insert for myself because I really wanted a way to track my reoccurring payments. Because that can really add up. I feel like you don't realize how much is like monthly going out until you see it on paper. So what I did was I added a column here for the occurrence. So if it's monthly, yearly, bi-monthly, or other. So I put like M or Y here, and this is what it is, and this is the price. So I really love those. Next I have to do just some paper in here, just regular paper. Next is my vision board, and I love this so much, you guys. It's so pretty. So this is a clear dashboard cover from Foxy Fix, and I just took a really pretty vision board I made of things that I like or that make me happy to look at, and I put it in here, and it's super cute. And I love being able to flip to it whenever I want to like look at it. I know it's kind of like might be a little silly to have its own section, but I don't know. I tend to forget to look around my planner, and I go just to like my weekly or my monthly, so it's nice to be able to just like go to a place and get inspiration. So on the same note, I have a quote section, and this section is all of these just beautiful quotes that really inspire me or uplift me, and I love having them all in one section, and I can just look at them whenever I need some inspiration or motivation, and I just love that. So I have Believe in Your Brand, Things Work Out Best for Those Who Make the Best Out of How Things Work Out. I love that one. And these are all available in our shop. I do have them up on our Etsy as well as our website, and I just love them. I think they're so beautiful, and they're just really fun to look at. We need a little pick-me-up. So my next section is my notes. These are all notes that I have, just random notes in my mind, things that I want to research or learn, and right now it's time blocking. I am super into that. I saw this one girl on Pinterest posted her like bullet journal, and she did time blocking, and it totally looks amazing. So I started researching it, and it is a really great way of planning out your day. So basically what you do is, well, I got these inserts to kind of try out. These are from Cloth and Paper, and they are the Lao Tzu, I'm probably butchering that name, inserts, but they are timed weekly. And basically with time blocking is you prioritize your tasks, and you block out pieces of time for that. And I think that it actually would really help, because I'm a list person. I'm to-do list person. And honestly, like when you're going just down your to-do list, you're not prioritizing like your urgent or need to do or important. You're just going down the list. But with this, I feel like time blocking can really help with that. So I got these inserts from Cloth and Paper. And basically what you would do is just write down your tasks, and then you would draw out like with a highlighter or a line that block of time. So I'm super excited to try that. I will definitely post some videos on how I do that once I get it done. Next is my wish list section, and I love this section so much. This is such a beautiful insert. This is from Think Then K. I'll link it below, and it is amazing. So what it is it has these categories up here, and I use our transparent dots to kind of color code it, and then I use my label printer to make the labels of what I wanted, and so then you can just write it down here. So you can put your category, your item, and your price, and these are kind of out there, but if you're gonna dream big, right? If you're gonna do it, do it. And I love this insert. It's so cute, and I love being able to color code it and like just quickly at a glance look at that. And then next I have my yearly section. This is a dashboard that we have available up in the shop. I just think it's so beautiful and clean and minimalist, and it's gorgeous, and I like to reference the week numbers that we're on and all that stuff. And next is my password section. And these are from Plan with Julie B, and I love, love, love these. So normally, all of the password inserts I've seen have, like, the website, the login, and your password. And that just kind of, like, unnerves me because I feel like if I ever, heaven forbid, lose my planner or something gets misplaced, somebody will have all of my information. So with these, it says source, login, and hint. Because I can pretty much hint at what the password is and know what it is, and I like that in case something happens, it just won't be out there, just floating around. So that is my setup so far. I will do another flip once I get the rest of the inserts in. I'm super excited. They actually should be getting here in a couple days, and I cannot wait. And I hope you guys love it. I will have all the links posted below of all the things you can buy in our shop, and all the links of the cute stuff from other shops, and hope you guys love it.